children, myself Saita Chaudhary, TGD science teacher from St. Joseph Public School, Tom. Students, in continuation of chapter number 4 of science, which is materials, metals and non-metals, our today's video's topic is chemical properties of metals and non-metals, part 1. So what these chemical properties are? Chemical properties, they tell us how these metals and non-metals, they chemically combine with other substances to form entirely new products with entirely different properties. So one by one we'll study chemical properties of metals and non-metals with different substances. And first of all, we are starting it with reaction with oxygen. How the metals and non-metals, they react with oxygen? Students, all the metals and non-metals, when they react with the oxygen gas, they always form their oxides. If that is a metal reacting with oxygen, that would be metal oxide. And if there is a non-metal which is reacting with oxygen, that would be called as non-metal oxides. Remember one more thing over here, that the metal oxides, they are generally basic in nature, and non-metal oxides, they are generally acidic in nature, and we are going to prove their basic and acidic properties also in our today's video. So as all these metals, they do not react with the oxygen gas with same intensity. Different metals varies their properties. वो अलग अलग reaction show करते हैं. Some of the metals, they are very reactive with the oxygen gas, whereas there are certain metals which are not that much reactive with their oxygen gas. Is there any criteria by which we can find out that which metals are more reactive and which are less reactive? Then the answer is yes. We are having one series named as reactivity series of metals. Students, with the help of this reactivity series of metals, we get to know that these metals are the more reactive, which are the moderate, and which are the least reactive metals. In this reactivity series, we are having the name of certain metals over here, starting from potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, silver, gold and platinum. And with the help of blue marker, I mentioned their symbols also. The symbol of potassium is capital K, sodium is Na, calcium is capital C and small a, and so on. So as this hydrogen, it is considered as a non-metal. Though its position is still uncertain, because hydrogen shows some of the properties of metals and some of the properties of non-metals, still it is majorly considered as the non-metals. So its non-metals se upar, bilkul top pe jo non-metals hain, like sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, right? These metals are called as the most reactive metals. जो बिल्कुल टॉप पे मेटल्स हैं वो मोस्ट रिएक्टिव होंगे. दोज विच लाई इन द मिडल, जो बिल्कुल सेंटर में प्रेजेंट हैं, दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज मॉडरेटली रिएक्टिव. एंड द मेटल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट बिलो हाइड्रोजन, दे आर कॉल्ड एज लीस्ट रिएक्टिव मेटल. सो दिस इज द इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ मेटल्स, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द बॉटम मूविंग टू द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. Now, is there any convenient method to memorize these all metals series in a sequence? There are certain interesting methods, students. Few are, which we have to discuss karte hain. Like, we can use these symbols to make interesting methods to learn sequence, the sequence of metals. The first we can use, K stands for kha, N stands for na, khana. CA can be considered as khaya, MG can be considered as maza, aluminium is aya, khana, khaya, maza, aya, G, fir, pet, hai, Q, aage, aya. In this way we can learn. There is one more interesting method, which is Kashi Nath ka Mali, Kashi Nath ka Mali, Alu जरा फीके पकाता है, राइट। काशीनाथ का माली आलू जरा फीके पकाता है। और वन मोर मेथड विच वी कैन यूज इज वी कैन यूज दीज वर्ड्स इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग देयर सिंबल्स, राइट। दैट कैन बी पोटेशियम कैन बी कंसिडर्ड प्लीज, सोडियम इज सैंड, प्लीज सैंड कैट्स मंकीज एंड ज़ेब्रास इनटू लवली हैप्पी केजेस सून जी, इंडियन ट्रेडिशंस। एंड मैं जी लगा रहे हैं when we are using the English methods also, right? So these are few methods you can make your own way to learn or memorize this table, because it is going to be very helpful to your students in your senior classes also. The activity series बार बार आपकी chemistry के अंदर science के अंदर काम आती है। So जो बिल्कुल topic matters होंगे when they will react with the oxygen, the reaction will be so vigorous, बहुत ही highly reaction होती है high level के ऊपर। जो बिल्कुल मॉडरेट मेटल्स होंगी उनकी मॉडरेट रिएक्शंस होंगी, एंड द मेटल्स विच लाई एट द बॉटम दे आर दे जनरली दे डू नॉट रिएक्ट विद द ऑक्सीजन, वो ऑक्सीजन के साथ रिएक्शन में शो नहीं करते हैं या बहुत लीस्ट रिएक्शन वो शो कर पाएंगे। अब इनको समझते हैं विद द हेल्प ऑफ द वर्ड इक्वेशंस एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल। लाइक द फर्स्ट मेटल इज द पोटेशियम ओवर हियर, फॉर दैट first we can write the word equation that you have learned children in previous video. For potassium I can write the word potassium. We are talking about reaction of metals with oxygen, that means this potassium metal is going to react with oxygen, so I am writing the word oxygen here. When these two reacts they are going to form metal oxides, that means that is going to form potassium oxide. In this case it is potassium oxide. This is the word equation. Now you know very well how to convert this word equation to the chemical equation by using symbols and formulas, right? So what is symbol of potassium? It is capital K. Symbol of oxygen is O2, and symbol of potassium oxide children, it is K2O. We can take one more example, which is second element, second metal, that is sodium. Directly we are writing the chemical equation here. Symbol of sodium is Na. When the symbol metal sodium reacts with oxygen, that means O2, the metal oxide, here it would be sodium oxide. And the formula of sodium oxide is Na2O. Students, these are the two highly reactive metals, and unki reaction oxygen ke sath itni strong hoti hai that if they are kept in open containers, agar kini open containers mein do metals ko rakh diya, in that case these metals are going to react with the atmospheric oxygen gas, and reaction itni vigorous hogi that accidental fire can catch over there, right? Wahan pe aag lag sakti, itni zyada heat wahan pe produce hoti hai. So precautionary method ke under sodium and potassium, neither they are kept in open containers nor they are immersed in water. Inko water mein bhi dip karke nahi rakh sakte, because in water also you know there is a dissolved oxygen gas present. So these metals they react with the dissolved oxygen also, and again the reaction will be so vigorous, so high exothermic reaction, that these metals are going to catch fire. So prevent all these accidental fires, what we can do, these are generally immersed in kerosene oil, because kerosene oil it makes a separate layer between the metal and the atmosphere, so oxygen ke contact mein nahi aa pate hain. Talking about few more metals, like hum baat kar rahe hain yahan pe magnesium ki, symbol of magnesium is Mg, reacting with oxygen O2, and it is going to form metal oxide. So magnesium oxide kya ho jayega, it would be magnesium oxide, the formula is MgO. So as along with that, I said one more thing, that metal oxides are generally basic in nature, and in 7th standard you have read about, you already discussed, got to know about the acids and the bases, aapko pata hai. To check whether these all metal oxides are basic or not, we can conduct a simple experiment, and that is dissolving these metal oxides in water. When these metal oxides are dissolved in water, students, they are going to make certain kind of suspensions or solutions. What happens when this potassium oxide, it reacts with water, it forms potassium hydroxide. When sodium oxide reacts with water, it forms sodium hydroxide. In the same manner, when magnesium oxide reacts with water, it forms magnesium hydroxide, and these are their formulas. Students, when we are going to check them whether they are acidic or basic, we can simply use litmus paper. All the substances which are acidic in nature, तो एसिडिक सब्सटेंसेस में अगर हमने ब्लू लिटमस पेपर डिप किया, देन दैट इज गोइंग टू चेंज इनटू द रेड कलर. एंड जितने भी बेसिक सब्सटेंसेस होंगे, इफ वी पुट देयर रेड ब्लू लिटमस पेपर ओवर देयर, देन दैट रेड लिटमस पेपर इज गोइंग टू चेंज इनटू द ब्लू कलर. सो चेंजिंग ऑफ रेड लिटमस इनटू द ब्लू कलर इज द इंडिकेशन of these substances, it is a proof that these substances are basic in nature. So till now we have discussed about the metals, how they react with oxygen and how they are proven that they are basic in nature. Let's talk about the non-metals also. हम कुछ non-metals की भी यहाँ पे बात कर लेते हैं, that how they react with the oxygen. Taking few examples, the first one is carbon. Students, carbon is a non-metal. When this carbon reacts with the oxygen, formula of oxygen is O2, and they are going to form non-metal oxide, and formula of carbon's non-metal oxide, that is carbon dioxide, CO2. In the same manner, when sulfur is burnt in the presence of oxygen, students, sulfur is also a kind of non-metal. So it is going to form SO2, sulfur dioxide. Again, metal oxides were basic in nature, whereas non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. कैसे प्रूव करेंगे इस चीज को? Again, dissolving them in the water, जब इनके हम वाटर के साथ रिएक्शन करवाते हैं, then this CO2, it forms H2CO3. So in this H2CO3 is the carbonic acid, and when SO2, sulfur dioxide, it reacts with the water, it forms H2SO3, which is sulfurous acid. नाम के साथ ही एसिड आ रहा है, प्रूफ होता है कि दे आर एसिडिक इन नेचर. अगेन वी कैन यूज द लिटमस पेपर टू चेक वेदर दे आर एसिडिक और नॉट. दिस टाइम वी यूज द ब्लू लिटमस पेपर, एंड ब्लू लिटमस पेपर को अगर इन सॉल्यूशंस में डिप किया, देन द ब्लू लिटमस पेपर इज गोइंग टू चेंज इनटू रेड कलर, प्रूव्स दैट दीज आर द एसिडिक इन नेचर. इनके साथ साथ एक बात और करते हैं यहाँ पे स्टूडेंट, दैट इज क्वाइट रेलिवेंट विद आवर टॉपिक, दैट इज रिएक्शंस ऑफ दीज मेटल्स विद ऑक्सीजन. इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज ऑक्सीडेशन. जब भी कोई मेटल्स रिएक्शन कर रहे हैं ऑक्सीजन के साथ, तो प्रोसेस को हमने क्या कहा है? ऑक्सीडेशन कहा है. यहाँ पे बात करते हैं द ऑक्सीडेशन प्रोसेस ऑफ टू कॉमन मेटल्स. फर्स्ट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द आयरन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन रेनी सीजन यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट द सरफेस ऑफ आयरन दैट जनरली गेट कोटिंग ऑफ द रेडिश ब्राउन कलर्ड सरफेस, कोटिंग बन जाती है उसकी सरफेस पे, and that red coating layer that is called as the rust, and the process is called as the rusting. And what kind of chemical reaction involved in that rusting? That is, this iron, it reacts with the atmospheric oxygen gas and water molecules. These are the two necessary conditions for rusting of iron. और जब इसका रिएक्शन करता है, it forms Fe2O3.XH2O. So it is typical formula. It is called as hydrated, क्योंकि water involved है, and Fe2O3 is called as ferric oxide. Hydrated ferric oxide is its chemical name. Common language में हम क्या कहते हैं? Rust. तो जब भी iron का oxidation होता है, necessary conditions kya hain? Oxygen and water. And what is formed? Rust is formed over here. And what happens when oxidation of copper? जब copper का oxidation होता है, आपने देखा होगा घरों पे copper के जो हम कई बार utensils घर पे use करते हैं, वो rainy season में they are generally covered with green colored coating. तो वो green color की coating कहाँ से आती है? Big question arises here. तो उसका answer यहाँ पे इस chemical reaction से prove करते हैं. So this copper, it reacts with all the substances. It reacts with the oxygen, carbon dioxide. एंड वाटर सबसे रिएक्शन कर जाता है एंड रिएक्शन करने के बाद व्हाट इट मेक्स CuCO3 डॉट CuOH होल ट्वाइस आई नो वेरी वेल दीज बिग फॉर्मूलाज आर क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट टू मेमोराइज इन 8th स्टैंडर्ड बट यस दे आर इंट्रोड्यूस इन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक दैट्स व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग देम सो दिस CuCO3 डॉट CuOH होल ट्वाइस स्ट्रेस इट इज कॉल्ड एज बेसिक कॉपर कार्बोनेट विच इज जनरली ऑफ ग्रीन कलर और इसकी वजह से कॉपर यूटेंसिल्स के ऊपर ग्रीन कलर की कोटिंग आती है लेट्स वाइंड अप टुडेज वीडियो विद द लास्ट पार्ट दैट इज दैट मेटल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट एट बॉटम ऑफ द रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज लाइक गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर दे डू नॉट रिएक्ट विद द ऑक्सीजन गैस एट ऑल सो इन नेक्स्ट